Hello, Retroburn here. Today I'm going to show you the results of an experiment to see whether the easy-to-build First Strike Plague Marine champion can be magnetized. The result is, of course, a resounding yes, and this video will show you how. To those who are new, if by the end of this video you consider this to have helped you, please consider subscribing and clicking on the bell icon to get notifications. I regularly post content at least once every 2 weeks. These clips encompass unboxing videos, faction-focused videos, and conversion and kit-bashing ones. It's all free and you can always stop following anytime. If you do decide to subscribe, thank you. It would be very much appreciated. The video is broken into the following sections. Why I decided to make this video. Summary of my magnetization process. Magnetizing First Strike Plague Marine Champion Torso and its backpack with a plasma gun. Magnetizing a Plague Marine backpack. Magnetizing First Strike Plague Marine Champion's right shoulder joint. Magnetizing First Strike Plague Marine Champion's power fist. Magnetizing First Strike Plague Marine Champion's left shoulder joint. Magnetizing First Strike Plague Marine Champion's plague knife. Why I decided to make this experiment? The answer is simple. I'm currently theory crafting 500 point Death Guard rosters, and the one from the First Strike box set has a loadout that I deem to be excessive in some lists. The guy has a power fist and a plasma gun. I need a plague champion that can fit inside a small army. His loadout needs to be diversified into modular ones that I can swap in and out depending on my list and army playstyle. The process is simple and, except for a few bits here and there, is exactly identical to my Warhammer 40k Magnetizing a Plague Marine Champion Death Guard guide video. Check that out if you're curious. A YouTube card should be appearing on the upper right corner right about now. Summary of my magnetization process. Before we go into the video, it's better if I give you a summary of the process so you can easily follow what I'm doing in the vid. This process, which is largely the same for all the surfaces to be magnetized, is as follows. Dry fitting to see how the parts connect. Determining the exact center of the surface where you want your magnet to be glued on by tracing lines with a knife or a pin. Some might find this step unnecessary, but for me, it helps. Scoring that point with a knife or a pin. Drilling the hole. If you're having difficulty with this, you can choose to widen the hole first with a knife. Taking a couple of magnets stacked together and dry fitting half of that into the hole. Note, if you've a magnetized model already, it's better if you stick this stack onto one of the magnetized miniature's magnetized points. This way, when you dry fit the new magnets into the hole you just drilled, you can ensure the bit you're gluing one of the new magnets into will stick to the old mini. Otherwise, you run the risk of having bits that will repel each other. You can regard the old mini as a seed of sorts on which you can stack new magnets to be glued on to other bits to ensure you've the correct polarity among all your bits. This ensures all loadouts stick to the torsos of your other models. Remember this, as this was my first major mistake when I started on this hobby. Dropping a tiny dollop of super glue into the hole. Wiping off the excess if you've deposited too much of the stuff. Pressing the new bit onto the sack. Sliding off the bit. Repeating the process, except this time you drill the other piece you want this new bit to connect to, and stacking a new magnet onto the magnet you just glued. Magnetizing First Strike Plague Marine Champion Torso in its backpack with a plasma gun. So with the process summarized, here's the first bit. The easy-to-build Plague Marine Champion's torso, specifically the rear part. The neck area used to have a protrusion, but I saw that off using a craft knife. I learned from my friend Marco, though, that Tamiya sells hobby sauce. It makes the job easier. Here are a couple of Instagram photos showing how I cut into a similar piece. Afterwards, it's the same process I outlined. Dry fitting, determining the exact center of the surface. An additional tip, now, off-centered arms won't be immediately apparent, but with backpacks, you need to ensure they are aligned right. With this bit, I decided to add an additional step by painting the magnet and pressing it to the back of the Marine. Scoring that point. Drilling the hole. Taking a couple of magnets stacked together and dry fitting half of that into the hole. Dropping a tiny dollop of super glue into the hole. Wiping off excess super glue. Pressing the new bit onto the stack. Sliding off the bit. The only problem I had with this project was the backpack's hole was too large and too deep. I inadvertently pushed the magnets deeper on my first try. In the end, I decided to just glue the existing magnets that got pushed in. Magnetizing a Plague Marine backpack. After the backpack with the plasma gun had been successfully magnetized, I moved on to a backpack that's devoid of any attachments. The same process is followed. Dry fitting. With this bit though, there was no need to find the center nor drill a hole, as there's already a hole in the plane power pack. Conveniently, the hole is also right on this particular backpack's center. A magnet glued there will align perfectly with the one on the Marine's back. I did have to cut off the connector on its bottom half though. I then dry fitted it again to check if the connection was seamless. Taking a couple of magnets stacked together and dry fitting half of that into the hole. Dropping a tiny dollop of super glue into the hole. Wiping off excess super glue. Pressing the new bit onto the stack. Sliding off the bit. Magnetizing. First strike Plague Marine Champion's right shoulder joint. I then proceeded to work on the Marine's right shoulder joint. Again, the same process is followed. Dry fitting. Determining the exact center of the surface. Scoring that point, drilling the hole, With this joint, I took the right arm from a first Plague Marine champion and made that as my seed joint. Taking a couple of magnets stacked together and dry fitting half of that into the hole. Dropping a tiny dollop of super glue into the hole. Wiping off excess superglue. Pressing the new bit onto the stack. Sliding off the bit. Magnetizing. First strike Plague Marine Champion's Power Fist. With the Power Fist bit, the hole is already there. The only steps to do were dry fitting. Dropping a tiny dollop of superglue into the hole. Wiping off excess superglue. Pressing the new bit onto the stack. Sliding off the bit. Magnetizing. First strike Plague Marine Champion's left shoulder joint. I then proceeded to work on the Marine's left shoulder joint. Again, the same process is followed. The left arm of the First Strike Plague Champion has a very flat connecting surface, so I didn't bother to dry fit it. Instead, I did dry fit the left arm of my First Plague Champion. Dry fitting. Determining the exact center of the surface. Scoring that point. Drilling the hole. With this joint, I took the left arm from a first Plague Champion and made that as my seed joint. Taking a couple of magnets stacked together and dry fitting half of that into the hole. Dropping a tiny dollop of superglue into the hole. Wiping off excess superglue. Pressing the new bit onto the stack. Sliding off the bit. Thank you. Magnetizing, First Strike Plague Marine Champion's Plague Knife. The First Strike set makes no mention of a Plague Sword, so even with the size of this thing, I'm assuming that this is a Plague Knife. Both cost 0 points, and both weapons are almost the same size, so you shouldn't have vis-a-vis issues with opponents. With this bit, the hole is already there. The only steps to do were drive hitting. Widening the hole. Dropping a tiny dollop of super glue into the hole. Wiping off excess super glue. Pressing the new bit onto the stack. Sliding off the bit. Can the First Strike Plague Champion be magnetized? Yes! Even the cape parts from the Plague Champion in the Plague Marine box, if you've magnetized them, are compatible with the figure's joints. Before you go though, some tips. 1. Make sure your drill is sharp. I had to spend several minutes carefully applying enough pressure that my drill bit can do its work. It's tricky as applying too much force makes you run the risk of breaking your mini and or the bit sliding off the mini and into your hand. Trust me, corn offerings are not fun. 2. Before dropping a dollop of super glue into a hole you've made, make sure your magnet fits snugly by dry fitting it into the cavity. 3. You might find out you haven't drilled enough after you've dropped super glue into the hole. Fret not, just wipe off what you can and continue drilling. This makes it even easier for you as the super glue will melt the plastic, making drilling easier. Just be careful with the smaller parts though, or minis with thin shoulder joints. Also, ensure no super glue sticks to your drill bit, as a super glue encrusted bit will be harder to work with. 4. If after drilling you find too much stubborn particles on the lip of the hole you've made, sand the surface to remove them. It would also make for a more even joint, making fitting bits together easier. And that's it! You've seen my magnetizing a Death Guard Plague Marine Champion Guide Warhammer 40k First Strike model video. This has been Retroburn, and if you like this video, please drop a like, share, and or subscribe. Drop a comment too! I'd love to chat with you. Happy gaming!